So Dick Holmes, in 1969, that's when he started this project. He comes to this space west of Watershed 6, and he looks at this forest, and he wants to know how many birds are in a 10-hectare plot.
My name is Miranda Zammarelli. I study behavioral ecology and population biology. For the past couple years, I've been digitizing and analyzing over 50 years of songbird territory maps from Hubbard Brook Experimental Forest. These maps show observations of birds from a single species and their territory locations on a 10-hectare plot at Hubbard Brook. Hubbard Brook is an experimental forest that allows researchers to study ecosystems and the environment. Hubbard Brook is a great place for research like this because the birds are easy to ID via song and also map in this type of environment. Dick Holmes, a professor emeritus in the Department of Biology here at Dartmouth College, created these maps from 1969 to 2021. From analyzing these maps, we learned that songbirds adjust their territory sizes to changes in abundance, which keeps their population stable and also can make them less vulnerable to changes or disturbances. This flexibility across different habitat qualities might make these birds more resistant to changes in habitat loss, but also could potentially have implications for how these birds respond to climate change. I think a main takeaway for bird conservation is that while it's important to focus our efforts on high quality habitat, it is also important to focus our efforts on low quality habitat because they could be equally valuable for birds. It has been rewarding to continue and build upon Dick Holmes's work, and I'm excited to see what the future of bird research holds at Hubbard Brook.